when people look at the mangrove, they see the mangrove as somewhere that's, you know, smelly or muddy or dirty. But mangroves are special because they are able to grow in a place where no other tree can grow and perform the same function like a terrestrial tree would, protecting the shoreline from coastal erosion.
A lot of people live right at the edge of the land, and most people like to live on the sea as well. I don't think they would be able to live right next to the ocean without mangroves, because the soil would just keep eroding.
Mangroves provide a natural coastal barrier against the impacts of climate change. You know, we have tsunamis, we have sea surge, we have strong winds. It's a haven for all the different kinds of marine life, which humans depend on as well. Mangroves are becoming a solution to climate change because they store 50% more carbon than terrestrial trees.
The biggest threats to the mangrove around here are rapid unplanned coastal development, degradation from land reclamation, as well as local threats from cutting.
The communities around the coastal areas, they depend mostly on their marine resources, so mangroves, fisheries. So it's important to work with the community to get them to sort of understand how they could still depend on the marine resources, but then in a sustainable way. The Mangoro Market Meri program is basically about the equity side of conservation, linking mostly women to markets to sell their marine resources. So if we're looking at crabs or mangrove products that they can do, it's also about finding alternatives to sustain them while they do conservation in their areas. So we work mostly with women because around this parts you find most of the women working in the mangroves to collect firewood, to collect crabs. You'll find them in the mangroves while the guys either have a job or they go fishing, but the mangroves are entirely left to the women to get resources out of.
It's a patrilineal society, so when it comes to decision making around conservation, it's a decision that the men in the community make, and women are not necessarily part of that decision making process. So the Mangoro Market Meri program kind of creates a platform where we work with communities to empower the women that have knowledge about mangroves to make decisions around how it's managed. The other objective is increasing awareness around the importance of mangroves and why we should protect them. So that's the education bit. There is also the objective focused around blue carbon. How do we link communities to blue carbon markets as a solution to climate change, but also as an incentive to conservation? We also have established nurseries within communities. In order for restoration to be successful, you have to have good nursery techniques to be able to allow seedlings to grow well and healthy before you bring them to a restoration area. And when we set up nurseries like this in communities, we run trainings.
I went two trainings with TNC, teaching us what is the importance of mangrove, how to look after mangrove, what will mangrove bring to our lives. From what I learned from TNC, I shared with the boys here, with my dad here. Then we started this small nursery in here.
The incentive is we pay them for each seedling that they nurture. We buy the seedlings from them and then go and do planting.
We've replanted 3,000 plus seedlings already. We are looking at in the next 5 to 10 years bringing that figure to about 200,000.
They are giving us knowledge to restore it. We have to replant it, so it must grow again. If we don't replace it, then in the future, our children will suffer.
It makes me happy when communities take ownership of the project, because you know that the project is going to be sustainable.
It gives me hope that we're doing something to protect these unique and critical ecosystems, contributing to protecting biodiversity and providing a solution to climate change.